Okay, friends, I think you're now aware of what has happened in Romeo's and Juliet's life. It's just a small version that we have understood. The poem is clearly understood. What happens to Romeo, what happens to Juliet, we are not bothered. All we are bothered is how to write their answers. The answers that we have, we will be getting in our questions, the 4-mark questions, the 6-mark questions, how to finish them off. Because once we have read Romeo and Juliet, we get various thoughts in our mind. We have our own explanation of our own feelings about love, but nobody wants that. Everybody, every evaluator just wants what Romeo felt for Juliet, what Juliet felt for Romeo, not what your feeling for somebody else is. So let us concentrate on the questions and the answers that we have to do. Your question bank, your question booklet, it has all these questions. Important 4-mark questions from the poem are this. What were Romeo's feelings for Juliet? What were Juliet's feelings for Romeo? You don't have to write down the whole poem. Some of the students make a mistake of writing down the whole poem by hearting it line by line, word by word, and just write it down. We don't want the poem. We want to test how good you people are in putting the answers in your own words. So make use of your grammar, make use of your sentence formation, and write down the answers as far as possible in simple but in your own words. Do not try to reproduce anything. Please remember one thing, English is not learnt by hearting anything. You have to understand and then you have to write it in your own words. When you are writing the answer on Romeo's feelings for Juliet, we all know we'll be writing about Romeo coming there and standing. She doth teaches the torches to burn bright. That is how it starts. You just write down the sentences and in between, please note that you will be using the words from the text. You will have to, in fact, that is called like quoting the words. You have to quote the words from the text. When I was explaining to you about Romeo's feeling and Juliet's feeling, I've also told you that you need to underline certain words. Remember, dear friends, you have to underline the words that you have quoted from the text. Once you make a quote of it, once you start underlining it, you will be drawing the attention of the evaluator towards whatever you have written. So as far as possible, let your handwriting be slightly legible. Let it be neat and clean. The second PO students, you will be happy if you know that you will have ruled paper, not an unruled paper. The PU board is generous enough to give you ruled paper, ruled booklets. So you don't have to worry that your words and sentences will go crooked. You will be writing on ruled paper. Underline that. Probably if the same pen, with the same pen you are writing, or if you have time, you can do it neatly with pencil. But don't do that wavy thing and all those things. Just plain lines will be fine. We can understand that you have read the lesson, you have read the poem and understood it very clearly. Romeo's feelings for Juliet, all those important points like teaching the torches to burn bright, the snowy dove amongst the crows, the rich jewel in the Ethiopian ear, her beauty is very rich for use. All these things have to be mentioned. When you are writing that, please see that you underline them. These are Romeo's feelings. Coming to Juliet's feelings for Romeo, again, lot of personification is used. In the previous clipping that you have seen, you would have understood that we have already underlined and noted down certain personification words. So here also, you need to underline that. Romeo, come day in night. So that is how she describes her feeling. So she feels that he is the bright daylight for her. So that has to be written, that has to be understood and underlined. Again, when it goes on, the raven's back, the white snow on the raven's back, and a black eyebrowed knight, all these things. Finally, when you write down how she feels for Romeo, you will have to mention that he needs to be cut into stars, cut into pieces, Allah, cut into stars and then thrown, again underlined, face of heaven. Face of heaven is very, very important. You have to mention this whenever you write the answer. It has to be put into the face of heaven. All these things you write for this one. Again, these are the two important things wherein you write down these two summaries. The third question is a general one. Now the problem and the difficulty starts. Love at first sight, explain this with reference to Romeo's feelings. When you read the poem, when you read the summary, you would have understood how Romeo would have felt for Juliet. So you will have to write down using the same verses that are there, that are prescribed in the textbook. As far as possible, don't try to put your feeling into Romeo's mouth. Okay, let him not be your mouthpiece. Don't write anything personal. You just have to write down whatever is given there. You just have to mention the same words and then tell us, tell the evaluators, tell your teachers how he had felt for Juliet in the first sight. Next thing is, the next important question is, what similes does Romeo use? Again, you have to mention only the similes. Please understand, when a question like this is asked, you don't have to write the whole poem. Don't write anything about Shakespeare. Don't write anything about the Capulet and the Montague family. We don't want the pros and cons of these verses. We just want to understand how much of the language you have understood. Just write down only the similes. If possible, try to explain these similes in connection with Juliet's beauty. And that will be completing your 4-mark questions. Remember, dear students, that is given to you, please attempt to write. Whether you write at least 5 lines or 6 lines or whatever it is, attempt to write. Remember, 4-mark questions, generally a decent page or decent length is almost 3/4 of a page. 3/4 of whatever booklet is given to you, 3/4 of that is a general and a happier length. Anything less than that, the evaluator is forced to give you only 3 marks. Anything more than that, the evaluator is again tempted to cut marks. So don't do that. Just stay within the limit and write down whatever is asked. Don't write too much extra or anything very less. This was about the 4 marks. Moving on to the 6 marks. Here really comes the question, really comes the difficulty. You will not be knowing how much to write for 6 marks. You will be confused. You feel for 6 marks, 6 lines is enough. Some of you feel for 6 marks, I think I'll have to write around 2 pages. We are also human beings. Evaluators also are human beings. They don't want to read the story. They just again want to understand how much you have understood. So the important questions, and this one could go on, you know, for a 6-mark question, the answer could slightly go and extend up to 1.5 pages, not more than that. 1 page, 1.25 pages, 1.5 pages must be maximum. Don't move more than that. That will be a very lengthy one. Evaluator loses interest in reading all your answers. 6-mark questions is the critical appreciation of the Juliet's and the Romeo's verses. Critical appreciation actually means how you felt looking at that. How can you critically explain that? Usually, you know, at your age, at second PUC age, nobody asks for a critical appreciation explanation. But still, when a question like this is given, you can write down the summary of it. How it was like, how did they see each other? How did they feel for each other? Just try to shorten the summary that is given to you in your text and in your prescribed book by the material here. You just try to shorten it and then finish it off with that critical appreciation. Now, comment on the imagery, night and day and black and white. Images are the pictures that are seen while you are reading the text. We have in Juliet's verse, she says, "You are my day in night." How these two things are contrasted. And the black and the white. Ethiop's face is black. Juliet's beauty is gold. So again, that is contrasting. How is it commented using all these things? Again, you have to slightly move above your standard and talk about love in the enemy families. Right? Parents hate the other parents. There is a lot of hatredness, going to the verge of killing each other. Okay, and in spite of that, there are beautiful small roses which are fond of each other. Two small young kids loving each other. That is love. So these are the contrasting images. How that is brought in favor of the night and day and black and white, that you will have to write. Again, here you will have to mention how these contrasting pictures are given. This is a slightly challenging question to you, wherein you'll have to write down how night and day again are explained without any confusion. Next, this one. It again, I think this comes to a personal level. Whose love is more passionate to you? According to my knowledge, these kinds of questions will not be asked, because again, it now talks about personal opinion. For me, Juliet's love could be more passionate, but somebody else, Romeo's love could be passionate. But anyway, we have to discuss this. Any person's love being more passionate, you can give, but please give proper justifications. Tell why you felt that that person's love was more passionate to you, and that will be sufficient. Of course, when you're writing here, remember again, I'm telling you, do not write your personal opinions. Try to take the words from the text, highlight them, underline them, and see that you just are within the limit, within the word limit. All the best.